One of the biggest action movies of the year was Mad Max, but now it's going to have its very own video game. Talking about Mad Max the game, what are you guys going to bring in this tale of Mad Max the game?
Well, we're going to try to bring the ultimate wasteland experience. We're going to try to give the players exactly what they would imagine that they would find in the world of Mad Max. And we also offer you the opportunity to be Mad Max and to build the ultimate wasteland war vehicle during the course of 50 plus hours of gameplay in a wasteland that's dense with exploration and cool scrap and brutal enemies and crazy people for you to kill.
What is it like creating a world around the world that we saw from the film of Mad Max and bringing that into a video game?
The greatest challenge for us is certainly to fill a wasteland. A wasteland, just listening to the name, you hear it, it's empty, right? Sure. There's nothing there, and that's what it's all about. It's about survival. It's about scavenging through the ruins and stuff like that. But we have to fill every part of this wasteland with cool shit for you to explore, and it's a really, really big wasteland. I would say that's the greatest challenge for us.
How are you guys mixing the on-foot gameplay as to the driving behind a vehicle gameplay? And how are you going to make it feel fresh and different every time we get in?
There is such a diverse range of upgrades for you to do in the vehicle gameplay. Also, a diverse range of different types of crazy ass enemies. Combatants that will jump from their cars and attack your car and hang on to that car and try to get into the car and kill you while you're driving. And I don't think that it can ever get boring, and especially since you can an almost infinite number of different types of upgrades for your car. The on-foot gameplay is equally the same. It's just, the more you play, the more interesting it gets. We try to weigh it so it has equal impact when you're playing, so that's what we try to do.
Tell me a little bit about how the on-foot combat is going to work. What is Max going to be able to do?
When we started talking about how Max would fight, we envisioned him as somebody who is very skilled at fighting, has, I would say, an amount of formal training, but an enormous amount of experience. His fighting style is that of a brawler more, but it's also somebody who effectively can take you out in an instant. We've had experts looking at it and stuff like that, especially during cutscene recordings, to get that kind of a vibe that this guy is, he can take you out anytime. But as far as battling other combatants, we just try to make it a very, very fun and engaging experience for you. And you will, of course, be fighting more than one guy at a time. For us, that has been our biggest challenge, to make that engaging and fun, make you feel like a badass, because that's what we really, really want to do. It's going to feel horrible to crack the neck of those guys and lay them down on your knees or shoot their belly out with a shotgun, but still you're going to feel like a badass, so it's a... It's like a lose-win kind of thing.
And with the driving elements, too, it's not just you're creating an ultimate vehicle and just driving it around for show. You guys are adding some unique abilities to the cars themselves as well?
Yeah, sure, certainly. And also we got something that we really got going for us is the Harpoon, which is something that's a little bit part of our heritage as a studio, because we made the Just Cause games before, and harpooning is what it's all about, really, that game. So we let that become part of this game as well, and it's really engaging gameplay, because you get to rip parts of armor off the other cars while you're driving in these intense, high-speed car chases, where you get that feeling you get killed in an instant if you do something wrong. And then you pick off armor and stuff from other cars, and then you open up their weaknesses, and then you can use your shotgun to blast them to hell.